When projecting in sketches, does it make a difference between choosing an edge or a face? On this knob, we want to create this recessed mark. One way to do that is to create a cross-sectional sketch on a plane that bisects the solid. In order to create this profile, we first need to project the existing edges and then create an offset. Press P to begin the project command. When we hover over a face, we see a preview of the projected line in red. If we hover over an edge, we see the same line. Let's try selecting these three edges and confirm. We have the resultant projected lines in purple. Go to Modify, Offset. Since we want to select all three lines, it would make sense to check the Chain Selection option. Let's select the line. The selection behaves as expected and all three lines are selected. Let's rewind to the project step. Instead of selecting the edge, let's select the three faces instead. Visually, there does not seem to be any difference compared to selecting edges. Let's try the offset. With the chain selection option checked, select one of the projected lines. Notice that only one segment was selected. Notice also that the offset appears to be in the form of a slot. The problem here is that when you select a face to be projected, this results in these two edges being projected, causing two lines to be stacked on top of one another. We can verify this by clicking on a projected line and pressing delete. Notice how the line still exists. The line is only completely removed when we delete it a second time. Another way to verify this is to press and hold the mouse over the line. This brings up a window that shows two sketch entities for selection, confirming that there are indeed two overlapping entities. The problem can be even more pronounced when more complex geometry is involved. In the case of this box, if I were to start a sketch on the right plane and project this surface, this will result in a stack of four lines. This will lead to unexpected behavior when it comes to chain selection and offsetting. This problem can also occur when selecting paths for sweeping and lofting. I would like to propose three recommendations when it comes to projecting. The first is, of course, to avoid selecting faces. Try to select edges whenever possible. Second, instead of borrowing entities from solid geometry, try to leverage on existing sketches. Going back to our first example, the solid was created by this sketch profile. During projecting, I can simply turn on the visibility of the sketch and select the sketch entities for projecting. A third recommendation is to use the Intersect command. Go to Create, Project Include, Intersect. In this command, Fusion looks at how the active sketch plane intersects with the solid and converts those intersections into sketch entities. In this case, you can select faces without creating overlapping lines. In general, we want to make our sketches as clean as possible so that they will behave as we expect them to. Hope that you have found this video useful. I will see you in the next one.